Hey guys, so since a lot of people ask us how we create our tutorials lately, we wanted to give a quick overview. So the first thing is if you open up the map utility lecture, that's the one we use for our intro maps. And first of all, I'm going in there, removing all the stuff Ansgar did for his overlapping tutorial and making sure there's only the things I really need in there. The next thing is to change the title. So in this case, I recorded the crab component intro. It's already released on our channel. For this, it's really simple because I'm not adding any specific blueprints, but if you want to explain something, here's a perfect place to add it. This thing here is our PowerPoint slide. So we have a PowerPoint slider. You can add slides to it. You can define a text. And you can also add a texture and scale the texture. So in this case, let's just pick a simple example image here. So maybe this one. And now this would be our first slide. I can scale the texture. And I can give it a subtitle. So in this case, the image is a little bit too big. So let's scale it down. And you can add as many pictures as you like there, and with this pointer you can just go to the next or to the previous slide. So this is really handy, but I'm not using it too often. As you may know, Ansgar is much more relying on that. So the next thing is, here are our speaker notes. So on the right side you can just add your texts, and it's the same logic. If you had hit a big red button in front of you, you will go to the next text. So this is a very cool way if you need to have speaker notes. I'm speaking freely. I'm not using this one here, but Ansgar is relying on this one. And it really depends on the style and what you're going after, if you want to use it or not. So, and this is the red button. It's right in front of you. It's not visible to the camera. And there you can hit it to go to the next tab. So let's quickly create some infographic here for this tutorial. I'm using the diagram from Draw.io. It's a really great and free software, but I'm fairly new to it. So I'm not very good at using it yet, but it's, from what I know so far, it's really great. And I'm going to use it much more often. We will also use it to create our documentation. So most of the images we create for our tutorials, we can also use for our documentation. So if you create something, it would be great if you want to share it with us. Maybe we can include it to the official documentation. So I'm always jumping back to Unreal to see if I have missed something here. And it's also the same for us. If you create a tutorial, we also go in there, test everything out, and really see what we need to explain. So let's save this image here, and once it is saved, I can go to Unreal and import it into my slideshow. So in this case, I'm going to add it to index 1 because I want to start with a blank screen. And I can switch the indexes above if I want to display the currently active slide here. So this is the VR view you have as a presenter. You can see the button, you can see your speaker notes there. There's the whiteboard, and I'm going to grab the presenter, and if I hit the trigger button, you can see I switch the slides there. I also have this pointer. If I press the trigger there, you can see it's extending, and I can really nicely point on things there. So let's switch the actual mode. If you press 2 on your keyboard, you can switch to the spectator screen and see yourself in VR. And this is the screen we are also recording. And one thing I noticed here is that this is the avatar of Ansgar. So of course I'm going to change this to my own avatar, and you can create your own also. It's just make a duplicate of our pawn and change it the way you like. So in my case, I have this cappy. And now if I hit play and press 2 again, you can see here's my avatar. And Now I'm actually ready to start recording the intro. And this is the actual shot I used for this grabbing component intro. So I'm not going to show you all of this here. And let's continue with the next steps you need to know. So after the tutorial was recorded, of course you need to record all your in-game footage, but it's just the same way, nothing special there. I use OBS for that. And after everything is recorded, I'm going to cut it inside of DaVinci. DaVinci is also free. And I have a template with our intro, our outro, a little header thing. And now I can go in there, just throw the tutorials, the intro and the actual tutorial in there, and start cutting. So there are a lot of great tutorials about DaVinci. It's really a great piece of software for cutting and for creating your text overlays and also creating the audio. Because one thing I'm doing is I'm not recording the audio while I'm recording the video. You could of course do that, but I find there's too much distraction on the one side, and the other side there's too much background noise if you hear the keyboard typing all the time. And also the mic from the Oculus Quest is not that great if you're in VR. So I'm just recording the videos and doing all my voiceovers after the cutting. And this way I also know what to say and when to say and where to cut. So, but this is really a matter of personal opinion here. Just try out for yourself what you like best. For recording, I use OBS. It's also a free software where you can just record your screen and also mix together different input streams and output streams, and also record your audio if you want to. And also there are a lot of great tutorials about OBS, so if you want to check those out. So I'll be back after cutting all the video. So the last thing is to actually add the subtitles to our video and add the header to all of it. Also, I use the crossfade effect between my cuts. And after everything is in there, it usually looks something like this. So now I can go in there and start recording. So I have this voiceover line here. I need to select my microphone under the input settings here. So I'm using a mono layer here, so I can just patch both channels into one of them. And now you can see as I'm speaking, it will start recording once I hit the record button. And yeah, now I'm good to go. Can start watching what is happening here on one monitor. Just for the purpose of this tutorial, I'm using only this one monitor here, but of course I have multiple monitors and it's much easier to handle all of this. So as the video is playing, you can start talking about what is actually happening here. So after rendering everything out, of course we need to add the description and the title and the text, the playlist, the outro from YouTube. So we add everything here. The last thing we need to do is find a good thumbnail picture. So I'm just grabbing it out of the video I just rendered. So take this one here, save it up, and use this as a thumbnail. And this is basically all the process for creating one tutorial. So depending on the topic you're creating, you really need a lot of preparations. Don't be frustrated if one tutorial may take you like a whole day to create, so 8 hours just for a 10 to 20 minute tutorial. It's totally normal at the beginning. And yeah, I hope this helps a little bit to understand our process. And as I said, all the programs we use here are free, and there are a lot of tutorials on how to actually record videos with OBS or to cut something with DaVinci Resolve. So, thanks for watching, and I'm going to see you in my next tutorial on Tuesday.